Ted! Dad!
Marcus, this is a surprise.
I have a favor to ask you. Is this a good time?
Well, why wouldn't it be a good time?
Well, it looks like you have company. Do I know her?
Come on.
Stroke Meg's cheek. Sometimes that helps get started.
Okay. There we go. Little sweet thing.
Adorable. Sometimes stroking the cheek gets things started.
That's the second time you said that.
Did I?
Sorry.
So how did it go with Griffin last night?
Who said anything about Griffin? Nothing happened last night.
Ooh, you hear that, Meg? That's what we call a lie.
Ed?
Hi.
You got a minute?
Yeah, sure. For you, anything. You want some, coffee or something?
No. Listen, I want to thank you for talking to Rick about us. I mean, he apologized for pressuring me to take that test.
Oh, but that's all right. It would just be so much better for everyone if Rick just forgot about the fact that the two of you...
I'm sorry, Dad.
I've done a lot of really dumb things in my time, you know, but it's like I told Rick, biology does not make a parent. And the more he thinks about this, the more he will realize that he's got to let it go.
Oh, excuse me. I think it's going to be Ross. Hello, darling.
Hi, Pumpkin.
Rick?
You're one and only. Well, not quite.
What are you doing calling me on my cell phone?
Because I didn't get a chance to see you before I left town.
Where are you?
Well, I'm on my way to Alan Michaels' wedding.
You're on a plane?
A Spalding jet, heading to an unknown destination with a plane full of lunatics.
Sounds fantastic.
Oh, it's just beachy. Everybody on this place just loves each other.
Stop rambling long enough to tell me why you're calling me.
Oh, yeah. I left a little surprise for you back at Springfield.
You know, Buzz, I like to think that Alan Michael inherited his romantic side from me.
Wow. Yeah, except when he got the girl, he got to keep her.
Excuse us.
Where are you going?
Buzz, have you ever been skydiving?
Have you ever spent an honest day in your life?
Spare me the fresh vitriol. I'll wait for the cameo.
Chew on this, A.S. I'm on to your scheme.
You mean to have you quarantined when we land, huh?
No. Advantage Systems is trying to take over Fistry, you know.
That's old news, Buzz.
Well, this news just in. You are Advantage Systems.
You can say it over and over again, but it'll never be true.
Alan Spalding, A.S. Advantage Systems, A.S. It fits like a noose.
No, you'd better shut him up.
You're slick, baby. But not slick enough. Not for me. Not for my mate. Isn't that right, honey bunch?
That's right, sweetie pie.
Baby.
Want some?
What's up?
Good afternoon. Thank you for flying Mesa Airlines. Sit back, relax, and enjoy your trip to Orlando International Airport. Our flight time today is 3 hours, 40 minutes.
Well, here's to a wonderful trip, everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Spalding Festa.
Dad.
You're the AS behind Advantage Systems, aren't you?
Yeah, let's all start this, okay?
You know, Buzz, only you could turn a coincidence into a conspiracy. Oliver Stone will be happy to know he's not alone.
I got you dead to rights. You're trying to destroy Fifth Street, baby.
Yeah, but why don't you just prove it, you little twit?
Don't speak to my husband.
I'll get proof. Come on, I'll get you proof.
Come on, but I'm not going to hold my breath.
Look, Buzz, listen to me. I know it bothers you that your diner was closed down, but I asked my father, and he said he had nothing to do with it, okay? I believe him.
Please, and you promised me that you weren't going to start this.
I don't know. It must be the altitude and the attitude.
It's not an excuse. This is my wedding, Dad.
Honey, my life is going down the tubes.
Thought it already gone there, but...
Dad!
Advantage Systems is not the only company with the initials AS. There's Allied Signal, Amalgamated Systems...
Right. Enzo Stores.
Since when are you on his side?
That's not the point. The point is that I'm keeping my promise to Lucy. We're keeping this a trouble-free wedding, right? Mm-hmm. And unless, of course, you want to ride in cargo, that's exactly what it's going to be.
Well, if you put it that way.
I know you don't get along with Alan.
There's a reason for that, you know.
But if you could just try to put the past in the past and focus on the future, we're going to a wedding, my wedding, which is something that is based on love and faith and trust.
You could learn a lot from your daughter, Buzz. I have.
Don't condescend to me, you...
For what I hope is the last time, I had nothing to do with Advantage Systems' alleged takeover of Fifth Street.
Yeah, right, and Oswald acted alone, didn't
he? Buzz, please.
Just, I hope this will, shut you up.
A letter bomb. You really shouldn't have.
Buzz, you heard Lucy.
Why don't you just open it and then apologize?
Cupcake, are you still there?
Yes, Rick. I'm here with your father. We were just talking about you.
My dad's there? Don't let him know about this little surprise, okay?
Got a better idea. Don't tell me about it.
Blake, listen to me. I left blood and hair samples back at the Cedars lab in case you decide to take the CBS test and match up some DNA.
I told you that's not going to happen.
Blake, don't you want to know for sure if Ross is the father of these twins?
How did you find out about that?
Dad told me. When were you going to spring this on me, Pumpkin?
Listen to me, Harpo. Whenever you get to wherever it is that you're going, I want you to check yourself into a psych ward and tell them that you're paranoid, delusional, and two-faced. You told me you were going to leave me alone on this one.
I am.
You're stalking me with my cell phone.
Blake, I gave you everything you need to shut me up. Take the CVS test. Prove to me that Ross is the father of these twins. Then Curly Boy will leave Party Girl alone, capiche?
I don't need a test to tell me what I already know, capiche.
Why didn't you tell me there were twins, Blake?
I was afraid you're going to be twice as obsessed.
I am not obsessed.
Let's add denial to your list of mental problems, okay?
Listen, I want to talk to him. Can I just...
No, I can handle this. Right. I can. Leave me alone, you big bully.
The reason you kept this from me, Pupkin, is that you're just as crazy about this as I am.
This is so untrue.
Then there's no reason to not take the test, right?
I can't hear you, Rick. I think the batteries are running lower. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Blake, don't hang up on me.
Rick, well, what's going on with you, huh?
Oh, hey, Dad. Listen, if we have a problem with the transmission here, it's a solar flare thing. Good. Okay?
Oh, come on. I thought you were going to drop this baby business.
Uh-huh. Listen, did you get that message I left on the answer machine at home?
No, I haven't been there since I talked to you.
So you don't know about Michelle, do you?
How's she doing?
She's not here, Dad.
What did you say?
You heard me. She tried to sneak Jay on the airplane, and I wouldn't let her.
Oh, come on.
Well, I kicked him off, and she ran after him, so...
Well, I mean, for where?
I don't know, Dad.
Oh, damn it.
Solar flare. Counters. Prop. Day. Mayday.
He got to you, didn't he? Would you hate me if I had your son killed?
No. Not at all, if we could get a good group rate.
What do
you talking about? What, has Michelle done something wrong?
Look, let's concentrate on one mess at a time. I can't believe I'm going to say this, but why don't you just take that CVS test?
Oh, no, not you too.
Oh, please, I mean, Rick is not going to let this go. I mean, he's calling you from the stratosphere. He can't let it go.
I may check myself into a loony, but...
So just take the test, all right? And then you will know for sure that Ross is the father.
You don't really think that Rick could be the father, do
Honey,
you?
I am a scientist. I got to look at every angle here.
Is there something wrong with the twins?
I shouldn't have snapped at you, but it doesn't mean I'm lying.
If you don't want to talk about Griffin, that's okay.
There's nothing to talk about.
Vivian, I'm not the enemy. I'm your friend. Now, yesterday you told me the whole story. And together, I thought we decided the best thing would be for you to tell Griffin the truth about Jilly. So don't blame me for wondering if you did tell him or not.
I tried. I had to do something. I couldn't let them get romantically involved.
So I'm not understanding. What happened?
It was the last thing I wanted to happen. I started to tell him, but then I couldn't. There wasn't any other way to keep him away from Jilly.
You didn't.
I have to go.
Oh, my goodness. You did. You slept with him.
He could see that I was upset. He thought it was about Jules. He promised me that he would be there for me. I managed to blurt out Jilly's name a couple of times, but then I couldn't do it. He thought I was playing games with him, and he got angry. Believe me, the last thing I wanted to do was to jump into his bed. But when I started to leave...
He didn't.
Oh, no, no, hardly. He challenged me to tell the truth. He said if I left without being honest, it was over. Well, then I knew Jilly would be a target for him.
So you're staying?
Oh, I've stalled for time, trying to think of something else to say, and when I couldn't, he got angry. That's when I told him I wanted him. Hmm.
So you slept with your ex-lover to keep him from being free to date your daughter.
What have I done?
What, did you think I was going to stay celibate for the rest of my life?
Well, no, it's just, maybe you're human after all.
Yeah, maybe. So what do you want to see me about?
I need to borrow $1,000. I'll pay you back a little bit for my gig at the Towers every week.
Look, do I get to know what this is for?
Well, it's a loan, right? I'll pay you back.
I'm not worried about that, son. I just want to know what it's for.
I have to go to Florida.
So you playing a gig down there?
No. I'm going to be with Dahlia Creed.
Uh-huh.
She's being dragged down to Lucy and Alan Michael's wedding. She doesn't want to go in the first place. She needs me, Dad. If you don't give me the money, I'll pound my horn.
Son, this is a very delicate situation. Now, Dahlia's mother's determined that Dahlia not know that she's in prison.
I'm not going to blow the big secret, Dad. I just want to give her some support and spend some time with her.
Well, I don't think that Frank Cooper is going to welcome you with open arms.
Well, I don't care. That's his problem. He dragged her down there. She didn't even want to go in the first place. And she's acting a little bit weird. I think she might be thinking of running away or something. I just want to stop her from...
So you're planning to watch her 24 hours a day?
If that's what it takes.
Son, I'm going to give you this check. But it doesn't mean that I'm not worried about both of you.
Thanks, Dad. Yeah. And don't worry. I can handle this. I can handle this.
Hi, yeah, I'd like to book a flight to Florida. Yeah, Orlando. Can you book me on your first flight? Sold out. What about the flight after that? Let me make this simple for you. Book me on your first available flight to Orlando. What? You're kidding. No, okay, thank you. Thank you, bye.
It's the height of the season.
Dad, I can't get a flight for the next 2.5 days.
It's all right, son. Better luck next time.
I can still go. I can still go if you'll just let me, please, borrow one of your bodyguards for just a few hours.
Do I want to know what you're thinking?
No, probably not.
Well, you can take Rashid. Yes. But I want him back in one piece.
Dad, I promise. Thank you.
Thank you.
I owe you one.
No, you owe me 1,000.
Okay. You're right.
Rashid?
What is it?
Springfield Board of Health has decided to reconsider its decision to reopen Meals and Wheels.
Yes! Oh, that's
wonderful!
That's great. That's so good.
Thanks for coming through, Father.
Thank you. Yes, Alan. Thank you.
You're welcome. I don't expect Buzz to have the dignity to apologize, but I do hope this puts an end to all of this.
Oh, wouldn't count on that, brother dear.
No one asks you, sister
dear. I want to hear what Allie has to say.
Well, it's just that I doubt that Advantage Systems will just want to live and let live where the Coopers are concerned. I mean, given their already mean-spirited actions, you know, I imagine there'll be a little bit more grief. The hapless denizens of Fifth Street.
I wonder if Philip would agree with you, Alex. Why don't you ask the next time you speak to him?
You talk to Philip?
When and why?
Well, of course I spoke to Philip. Last time I checked, he was still a member of this family.
What are you up to, Alex?
Nothing, darling. Just as you.
What were you talking to Philip about?
Your wedding, of course. You wanted to know all about Lucy and such, and hope this marriage is going to fare better than the one to Eleni and Blake. Oh, don't take offense, darling. I've
always
adored you.
If Philip wanted to ask me anything about Lucy, why didn't he call and ask me himself?
Well, from what little I saw, Alexandra Graham Bell didn't give him much of a chance.
You know what? I hope this magical, mystical wedding of yours is going to be in Malibu, because there's something about that place that really grips me. Don't you find the people out there so engaging, Amanda? So eager to please, you know? Didn't you find that when you were there?
Oh, enough about me, please. This is about weddings. Let's talk about your engagement to Hawk Shane. Hey, why didn't you bring the old coot around?
Oh, because, well, he has too much dignity to want to be seen with me before his divorce from Sarah is final. I mean, unlike Reva, he doesn't like changing partners in midstream, midair, or mid...
Wait, hey, that's my wife you're talking
Buzz,
about.
No, Buzz, really, it's quite all right. You see, Pop has such slim pickings at his age. Gosh, it's good we have so much food on board. Anybody for pie?
Alex, I'm warning you.
About Philip.
Excuse me. I'll tell you about Philip.
He's got a wicked sense of humor.
Well, we've been best friends since we were kids. Through good times and some bad times. And when things were bad, they were really bad.
You're serious?
Yeah, I'm dead
serious. It's very funny, but I'm not joking, Rick.
I'm not.
It wouldn't be easy.
Well,
figured. I mean, first of all, you have to find a body, and that's no piece of cake. It has to be the right body, your height, your weight.
God, are we really having this conversation?
I think we are. Yeah.
We are.
Okay, you have the right positive ID, x-rays, dental records, and you have to work with somebody from the inside because there's no way that you...
What?
Would make me an accessory. My whole career would go down the tubes. I could go to jail.
I'm sorry. I didn't think.
No, you didn't! You didn't think! You obviously don't give a damn about me!
But that's not true.
What the hell were you expecting me to do?
Take care of the girls.
I will. Right? We'll do.
Especially Mindy.
Especially Mindy.
The way she's looking at you. She's crying her eyes out. You think she doesn't care about you?
We've got quite a history together, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
She'll always be the one that got away.
For now. Never know.
You're right. You never know. You're right. To blue skies, I think it's about time.
I love Philip like a brother, but he almost cost me my medical license.
Yeah, see, Philip never means to hurt anybody. It just seems anybody who gets close to him always gets burned.
We there yet?
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong with the twins. The bad news is Ed can't go to Alan Michael's wedding because he has to work.
Oh, Ed, come on. You're chief of staff here. Delegate the work.
No, you see, we're having trouble with the funding for a new cardiac wing. I can't pass the buck on this one.
Oh, too bad. If it's not one thing, it's the other.
Yeah. Well, I have some calls to make before I go back to the board meeting, so I'll see you.
Okay.
Bye.
Say, you haven't been to see your mother yet, have you?
No, I ran into Ed and then we started talking. How come you're not at work?
Because I don't want to be. I couldn't resist the temptation to come see Holly and Meg. It's sort of like a preview for our happy coming event.
Oh, how sweet.
Not as sweet as the smell of, let's say, talcum powder or something like that. In fact, I've been counting the days until the twins join little Meg in the playpen. What's the matter? Do you think I'm overdoing the Proud Pop a bit? Don't answer that. It's a rhetorical question. You cannot overdo the Proud Papa bit, can we? So come on, kids, Annie, Mom, let's go visit Meg.
Griffin got to you.
He's the same as always. No man has ever made a woman feel more wanted.
Well, you were right about one thing. Jilly really cares about him. She glows when she talks about him.
You talk to her?
She stopped by to see me. She couldn't say enough about him, how thrilled she is to be working for him, how wonderful he is.
I told you she was attracted to him.
It's not going to be long before she tells him how she feels.
He's a one-woman man. If he's with me, he won't be with my daughter.
Does that mean you're going to keep it up?
Keep what up?
This affair with Griffin.
It's not an affair. It was just one night.
Well, what if he can't wait to see you again?
Ladies, may I come in?
Bless me, Meg. Mama's psychic. Telling Meg she can expect a lot more company now that she's on the mend.
You know, I couldn't stay away. I just had to see how you and the baby were doing.
Excuse us. Room for three more members of Meg's fan club?
We can squeeze you in. Come on in.
Hey,
Griff.
Hi. I have to check my messages. Excuse me. Talk later.
I should be going too, Holly. Yeah, you give Fletcher my best, okay?
I will. Thanks for coming by.
Pleasure was mine.
See you.
Oh, waking up, waking up. Oh, look at those cheeks. Yes. Little hands, too. Oh, and that aroma of talcum. Good choice today, Meg. Good choice.
You sound almost as giddy as Fletcher. Don't go there.
Well, it makes for awfully good practice.
For what?
Ross?
Hmm?
Excuse me. It's time to take Meg back to the nursery.
Oh, yeah. Bye, sweetie.
Good to see you later. Say bye.
Bye, Meg.
She's falling out.
Oops.
Oh, you gotta hold me here.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank
See you.
Bye-bye.
Oh,
bye-bye.
Holly.
Hi, honey. She's so beautiful.
So sweet. Thank
you. honey, you wanna tell Holly the good news?
I really would. I wish you'd wait.
What? Tell me.
Why wait?
I don't know. I...
Somebody tell me.
Well, yes. I'm pregnant. I mean, she's pregnant.
You are?
Yes.
Oh, honey, that's wonderful.
And we're twins. Twins. We get two babies for the price of one.
Oh, honey, that's fabulous. Oh, goodness. You must be beside yourself.
Well, I can't think about anything else. Well, you were on the phone a long time. Hope everything's all right back in Springfield.
They're fine. Just talking to my dad about Michelle.
Oh, I could have sworn I heard you mention Blake.
Well, I did, because she was there when I talked to my dad.
Yeah, how are old Ross and Blake these days?
Well, they're doing fine. Well, certainly no thanks to you, Amanda. Blake told me all about you following Ross up to the cabin that night.
Oh, right. Oh, well, of course you'd know that was the night that you ended up going home with Blake.
Who told you?
Dinah. She showed up early the next morning to see Ross, and you were there. I personally had no idea that you and Blake were so close.
We're friends, Amanda. You should get when they're fun.
Nobody in this family talks about Philip. Is there a reason for that?
Well, I think it depends on who you ask.
So, how do you feel about Philip?
Well, you don't beat around the bush, do you, Lucy? I like that. I desperately wanted to do right by him, but as is my pattern, I failed at every turn. Out of Michael's problems, and mine paled in comparison with Philip's. If he was the golden boy, I tarnished him for life.
Well, now Michael forgave me, maybe Philip did too.
I don't think so.
Why not?
Because he was a lot like me. He can't let go of things, even when he knows he should. I love you, Philip. I love you more than a parent has the right to love his children. I don't want you to tell Amanda or Alan Michael, but you are my favorite. You always have been and always will be. That's why I want you to have this. It was worn by every heir to the Spaulding Empire since our humble beginnings back in the sugar trade. And I want you to have it, son, because I want you to take Spaulding Enterprises into the 21st century. Take my vision and make it your own.
Find another sucker, Dad. Because I'm on to you.
I don't understand.
Oh, well, I'll explain. See, I don't want any part of your vision. I've seen what money and power have done for you, and I don't want it. You know what? I would rather end up in hell and be somebody like you.
Philip was a victim of his own illusion, the illusion of who he was and who he could be. I just hope that he stopped and seen who he really is.
Well, no matter how he turned out, I think he's lucky to have a father like you.
Well, thank you, Lucy. Let's go back in to the party, okay?
Yeah, all right.
Come here, let me ask you something. Have you ever boogied at 40,000 feet?
No, I can't say I have, but you know what?
What?
We could dance together anytime. Why don't you ask Dahlia? She hasn't moved from that chair since takeoff.
That's a good idea.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, excuse me. Hi. Listen, would you like to dance? I mean, I'm really not an old fuddy-duddy, I promise.
No, thanks.
So I'm sure you could show me a thing or two. Come on, Dahlia.
Why don't you just leave me alone?
Dahlia, come on. Give me a break here.
Yeah, I'll do that when you give me a break. Now, you won't even let me talk to people.
I assume we're talking about Marcus Williams.
Well, he's nice. I like him, but you don't care about that, do you?
May I help you,
sir? I am Prince Chaka Benbuti of Muchineripi. My embassy arranged me to pick up my ticket here at the gate instead of the main terminal. Security issues.
Yes, of course, Your Highness. I'll get that for you right away. So you have reservations?
First class, of course.
I'm not showing any Benbuti in my records here.
Houston, we have a serious issue here. I am to speak today in Orlando at the Organization of Continental Nations. I am afraid to know what would happen if I am a no-show. Lives hang in the balance.
Well, let me see. I guess I can put this little kid on his mother's lap, give her a free return ticket.
I'll mention your heroism in my speech.
Wait a minute. Don't I know you from somewhere?
I was interviewed last week by Dan Rather.
Oh, no. Okay, of course. You're Marcus Williams. You're the sax player.
Blake and I wanted a baby so much, and now we end up having twins. I don't know how you did it, honey, but I'm glad you did.
Oh, boy. I'm nauseous. Excuse me. No, I need a woman. I need Annie.
Oh, I understand. All right. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Sweetie, are you overheated?
No. You know, I thought I could handle the pressure and live with the guilt. I can't. You know, I've got Rick. He's shown up at my house unannounced. He's calling me out of the frickin' sky. Ross keeps going on and on about the twins and my mom. She thinks that I have my life together. Not. Ed can barely look at me. And you think I should tell Ross the truth?
No, I am not judging you, Blake. I have been there and done worse. It's just I know what lies can cost a person.
So what, you think I should take the CVS test?
I want you to feel better, that's all. I don't want these babies to go to term in a whacked out mother.
Okay, all right, I'm gonna take the test. We're gonna do it my way though, right? Can we talk somewhere privately?
You bet, okay.
I can't believe how parental I feel. I mean, like overnight, I'm thinking in terms of what's best for the children. In fact, I don't think there's anything I wouldn't do for the kids.
That's the bottom line, isn't it? There is nothing we won't do for our children.
I couldn't keep my mind off you. I haven't been this happy in years. I dreamed about you all night long. Woke up this morning with a smile on my face. I could still smell your perfume on my pillow. I could almost feel your soft skin pressed hard up against me.
Stop.
You're not sorry we made love, are you?
I want you now as much as I wanted you then. But
I
I'm afraid you must have me confused with someone else. I am Prince Shaka Penbuti of Muchineripedia. It must be true what they say, that in America they have us all confused.
Denzel Washington, you're not. No, I've seen you play at the Towers. You're very good.
Marcus. I think he's got his English a little.
Brother, he's got you by the dashiki, all right?
Listen, man, okay, I'm no prince, all right, but I need to get to Orlando today.
Look, I told you, man, we're booked solid.
No, this is a matter
of... Yeah, I know, lives hang in the balance.
Maybe mine. Can I talk to you for a second? Hey, look, there's a girl who's there, all right? This woman, she's got one of those voices. One of those voices that makes you laugh and cry all at the same time. She is sweet. She's beautiful, man. She's by herself, and I have got to get there to be with her. Listen, I will fly with the luggage. You can put me in a pet carrier with a flea collar and a bone, but I have got to get to Orlando today, man. Please, please.
Man, you are as good with words as you are with a sax. Listen, I cut your act 3 times, and your solo on My Funny Valentine made my girlfriend cry. It kind of got to me, too. I asked her to marry me. Right there on the spot, she said yes. Wow. So I guess if anybody deserves to get where they're going, you do. All right. I'll bump this little kid on his mother's lap. You fly first class.
Oh, you are the best, man. Thank you.
Listen, next time you play the club, you dedicate a song to my fiance, we'll call it even.
Deal. I'll do you one better. Houston's Blues.
Okay, man. 15D.
Min!
Man with a pause, just like your father. Don't give up.
Not a chance. See you next week.
I didn't think that there was going to be anybody in here.
We just stopped in to discuss a fundraising idea that Griffin has for the Cedar Outreach Clinic.
Yeah, I'm glad you liked it.
Let's talk outside.
Oh, yeah. You don't have to leave on our count.
We were just finding a quiet place for Blake to rest a minute, that's all.
Yeah, I'm just a little queasy,
that's all. Just, we'll just leave you two alone.
Well, I hope everything goes all right.
Excuse me?
With the fundraiser.
You come to my hotel room as soon as you can, okay?
I'll make an excuse for Charles and call you. God help me.
The only problem is here, honey, drink this.
Thanks.
Is that you need a sample of Rick's DNA before the CVS test will prove anything.
Eager Beaver Bauer left a parting gift with the lab.
Then you're all set.
Yeah. Okay, I'll do it. I'll take the CVS test, or whatever test I have. I've got to know who the father is.
I think that's wise, Blake.
Okay, but this is on my terms. I control the records. I control everything about this pregnancy from here on in. I am the only one that gets to see the results of the test. Otherwise, the deal is off.
Doesn't love you. She's using you to get to me.
It just kills you, doesn't it? It just kills you that a woman would choose me over you,
you know,
right?
If you're into leftovers, little brother.
Are you miserable, son?
What are you gonna do? You mad now? You gonna take a swing at me now?
You know what?
Go ahead.
You know
Go
what?
Ahead.
You know what? I don't know why I ever looked up to you. You know, you're not a real Spaulding. I know you think you're the golden boy, but you're not a real Spaulding. I know you got the clothes, you got the attitude, you got the ego, man. But I'm telling you one thing. When it comes down to it, father's gonna choose his real son. His one and only son. And that's me.
I've decided to go ahead with our plans for Fifth Street. Advantage Systems will take over the entire area and then squeeze out Buzz Cooper and his new wife. Because no one takes what's mine and gets away with it.
Father Alan Michael is going to hate you. Are you positive that you want to do this?
He must never find out that I'm behind this.
But how can you be sure that he won't?
I will find a way. It will never happen. Come on, man.
He did.
No, I'm tired.
No. Oh, come on.
What? It's good practice for the wedding reception.
I am happy for my daughter. I'm sorry I was a jerk, but I don't think Alan's innocent.
Well, I don't think so either. But we're going to be wonderful at this wedding reception. We're going to be two good people, right? And then when it's over, we scour Orlando for the answers.
Okay, get everybody, please take your seats. The pilot is flying in low to see our mystery destination.
Come on, right over here.
Wait.
Have a seat. It's built for two. All right, now I want you to look right down there. See that? What do you think?
It looks like a movie studio.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's Universal Studios Orlando. And it's all yours, Lucy. It's all yours. It's all for you.
We're getting married there?
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, if it's okay with you.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. It's incredible. It's wonderful. Mm.